Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today we are gonna get into some autumn winter goodness with a slightly different video because I'm not entirely sure what this video is yet. I really wanted to do an autumn winter coat edit for you guys and really show you the best of the best that is on offer this autumn winter. But with the current stock levels and the way things are going, things are selling out very fast and coats and jackets seem to be coming in a lot later than they have in previous years, which is completely understandable due to different like production issues and things like that due to COVID. It's kind of put a stopper in my ultimate autumn winter coat edit. So instead of whittling my autumn winter coat edit down off camera, we're gonna do it together and it might help you guys because there might be something that I personally don't love but that you actually love and it really works well for you. So with that in mind, I've kept in a few jackets which are obviously a lot lighter, but for those of you that are in warmer climates, I thought that might be useful. And if there are any items that I spot in the run-up to this video going live, what I'll do is I'll just pop them at the end. They might not have a little like sit down bit like this, but I'll try and include trans of anything else that I managed to find at the end of this video. But first things first, we're gonna get started with what is, I think, my favorite coat from Zara this autumn winter. Ooh, can we say that? Because they might bring out something better, I don't know. Let's get into it. My gosh, I forgot how hard it is to hold coats up. Like, I feel like I haven't done this in the longest time in a video. How do I do this? So this coat is stunning. It is probably the most similar dupe I found for my Mango Coatigan, but with the lapels, it feels a little bit smarter than my Mango Coatigan. This is gorgeous though. It feels like very similar in terms of the material. Although this looks like a winter coat, it's not like double lined, so it is actually a lot lighter than it looks, although it still feels kind of heavy. So it's a wool coat and it's handmade, which does hike the price of this up. It is £129, which for Zara, I feel like is quite a lot. I got this one in a small, and you can definitely take your regular size or even size down because it is very big and very floaty. It's got nice big pockets, a tie waist, it buttons down. I love this. I can't wait to show you this on. I'm gonna get on with it and we'll get on to the try on. So this coat I really love. I think it works so nicely as like a smarter coat, but what I've done with the outfit that I've paired it with today is kind of casualed it down a little bit more just to show you how I would most likely be wearing it at the moment. I've paired it with an Another Stories really simple cable knit jumper. It's a very like classic style and a very classic fit as well. It's definitely like, if you want it to be oversized, you will need to size up. I think I've got a medium and it's only like a tiny bit like loose on me. It's definitely more of a kind of like fitted regular fit type of vibe. I paired it with my black Sydney jeans and then a pair of Zara boots. The three pieces definitely make a very casual outfit when you take the coat off. It's just very nice and easy. I feel like you will have seen this outfit underneath in a what I wore in a week video, but I love the mix of the coats thrown over the top. It works really nicely in terms of its tone with the cable knit. But something else that I really like about the outfit and what I think makes it look a lot more casual is how the sleeves on the coat are quite a regular sleeve. They're not excessively long, which I think most people will be pleased to hear. There's nothing more annoying than the sleeves on a coat being like ridiculously over the top long. But the sleeves on the jumper are a little bit longer, so they kind of poke out. And I know it's not gonna be for everyone, but I really like the look that it gives when you can see it poking out here, but also beyond the sleeves as well. It just looks very cozy, very autumnal, and yeah, I'm just really here for this coat. It is such a gorgeous autumn winter staple and such a classic that I feel like everyone would keep in their wardrobe for a really long time. Okay, so at the risk of making this video incredibly long, I wanted to give you guys a kind of dressy alternative to this Zara kind of camel coat. So underneath I've got a high neck jumper dress from Topshop, which I love, and I think it works so beautifully during autumn winter with like boots that come up quite high on the leg. I've paired it with my Chloe test bag and then the kind of matching Another Stories brown croc boots, just because I really love that pairing. Some people might hate it, I don't know, I just really love it. And as you can see, I've used the tie waist again on the jacket, but it has a very different vibe this time to the last time, and the tie waist allows a little bit of leg to pop through. It shows that you've still got legs there underneath the coat somewhere, you know? But yeah, that is the more dressy kind of vibe, and I really like the brown tones together, you know? This second coat from Zara is a real favourite of mine for the print. It's got a houndstooth print, which I don't know if it will show up so well on camera, but it's basically like a black houndstooth with little bits of tan and little bits of green on the second like houndstooth tone. It is so beautiful and the print is really small as well, so it's not super noticeable. I've just figured out recently that big prints are not for me. They don't suit me. They look far too busy, but a small print where from afar it doesn't even really look like a print works so, so well for me. I picked it up in a size small and it was $89.99, and I feel like this is quite a regular fit coat. It doesn't look like it's gonna be too oversized on me, and it's not too long either. So if you are shorter, then this is gonna work out really well for you in terms of like having a coat that doesn't feel like it's swamping you. And if you're taller, it will probably come into just below your knee. Unlike the other coat, this is double lined. It feels a little bit heavier, but it still feels very lightweight for a coat. And I think it's one of those ones that works really well to layering over other items. You could definitely get a hoodie on under this, and I think it would look really cool like that.
Sadly, this jacket probably is one of my least favorites from this edit. I really like the way it's been styled, but to me, it just seems like more of a transitional piece than a true autumn winter piece. It is very, very light, and that might be great for those in warmer climates. For me, I'm finding that when I'm putting like big jumpers on underneath, it's just looking a little bit too bulky, I guess, because the coat doesn't have a lot of structure, and actually it falls best when there's less like padding going on underneath. And I've just got I've got a black body on right now from Zara, and then I've got my new in mom jeans, which are just my absolute favorites, and my Veja trainers. And then I've gone for a little white bag because I think that it pairs really nicely with the trainers, and it brightens the outfit a little bit. The struggle that I was having with this jacket is because it's grey, it's just kind of like coming off a bit meh. And I really originally wanted to pair it with like the brown boots that I have and the brown croc bag, and it just wasn't vibing. So I've gone for something like a little bit more springy really. But I am kind of sad this didn't work out with any of my like serious like autumn winter staple outfits, you know.
Next is a jacket that you might remember if you've been watching my videos for a long time. I used to own basically the 2010 version of this coat, which I have to say, the quality goes down and down and down each year. Like the one that I bought in 2010, I think it might have even been 2009, was stunning. It was so weighty and so well made, and it lasted me until a few years ago when it actually just had like holes in it, and it had gone through flats that had damp and moths, and it was gross. And it was at the point where it had reached the end of its life. Like no one would have wanted to wear that coat. But I thought I'd pick up the 2020 version. I was about to say 2012, no. 2020 version and see what it's all about. The material now is definitely a lot like lighter, and it doesn't feel as soft as it used to. I picked up a small and it was £119. I don't know if I should have got a small, we'll see. I maybe could have done with a medium, but it's a lovely pea coat basically. If you're not familiar, I'm talking to everyone as if they know this coat, but it's a pea coat with this kind of like double-breasted, double gold buttoned chest. It is absolutely stunning, and I used to wear this. I'm gonna find a photo of me wearing this from like 2012, 2011. I feel like my hair was very similar then to how it was now as well. Nothing has really changed. Everything's changed and nothing's changed all at the same time. But I couldn't do an autumn winter coat edit without throwing this in. This is like an absolute classic winter coat, and I love it so much. It's very smart, but an absolute classic, and you will have it in your wardrobe for years and years and years. Okay, so the pea coat. Back in the old days, this would have been like a skirt and chunky boots kind of vibe.
But we're going for a little updated twist on this now. So I've paired it with my Zara leather leggings, but leather trousers. I have these in a size small. With the trousers, I've paired my sock boots. I believe these were from ASOS last year. If they still do anything like them, I will link it. And then my roll neck is from United Colors of Benetton, from a job I did with Amazon a few years back. And then I would also just pair my winter sunglasses. These are gonna be like the go-to sunglasses for this try on, because I just think they're the perfect pair of winter sunglasses. These are from Givenchy, and I believe they might have brought these back, but I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, that is pretty much the outfit. To be honest, in the winter, I feel like a lot of my wintry bags are like black or neutral colored, so pretty much go with anything, any coat, any outfit. But I do really like my tote bag from Dior with this one. Any kind of like big tote bag, I think, works really nicely. I think this outfit works very well either for evenings, more dressy occasions, or like work wear. Hear me out, I know it doesn't look like the most like corporate-y, but in terms of if you've got like a smart casual dress code, actually this fits the bill. In terms of if you work in an office where it's like no shoulders, no knees, no like open toe shoes, which is what I used to have in a smart casual office, this like ticks all of those boxes. You've got your nice roll necks when you take the coat off, it still looks smart. The leather trousers also look very smart, and the boots, they really pull the outfit together. So yeah, that's why I've gone for the bigger bag, because I just think it works. It all works and caters towards an office kind of look perfectly, but you could also switch out for like a clutch or a smaller bag if you are just doing something more social. Yeah, I do really love this look. It's such a classic.
And then we have a few lighter jacket options. This one I am particularly excited about because it looks like one that I believe I saw in All Saints. I think it was All Saints, which obviously costs an absolute bomb and it's just completely out of budget. But this one is very, very similar, and I thought it could be really cute, like with a pair of skinny jeans and some cute like heel boots. I think this one would work really well for whatever occasion. I got so small though, weirdly, the tag is not on it. How strange is that? I've literally just unboxed it. It was $49.99, which compared to the All Saints one, I cannot argue with. This one's a great option if you are not so much of a coat fan. If you don't like anything too chunky, this will work really beautifully with like a hoodie underneath. I've got lots of friends that just are not fans of like full-on coats, but could do like a cute little fluffy jacket. So I think this one is a really great option if that is kind of like how you feel about coats, because we've all been there at one point or another in our lives. I used to hate coats. But yeah, this one is so cute, so fluffy. Can't wait to style it up. I'm not sure if it'll make my official like edit of 2020, but let me know what you think. I think it's really cute. So for the little fluffy jacket, I have gone for a cream roll neck underneath in a similar tone to the jacket. I think it just works really nicely together. The jumper's not distracting from the jacket at all, but when you take the jacket off, what you have on underneath works really well together as well. I've got my Topshop Sydney jeans on, and then my ASOS boots. Because the hem of this jacket was shorter, I decided to go for a boot that was higher, because you kind of have a little bit less like jean going on. I don't know, I feel like it's a little bit more paired together than just simply, you know, throwing on a pair of trainers with this, even though you could obviously do that. I actually think this jacket would work really well with like a pair of like blue denim jeans and trainers, but my preferred way of wearing this, and the way that I think it looks so cool together, is a simple pair of black jeans, a simple little creamy roll neck to match the jacket, and then the boots kind of do the talking. What I'm doing with a lot of my autumn winter outfits is basically just letting my footwear and jacket do the talking, and then keeping everything else underneath very minimal, but something that I feel comfortable with. If you don't feel comfortable with the roll neck, you could go for obviously just like a normal round scoop neck. Scoop neck, is that the word I'm using? Is that right? Just your normal like round collar kind of jumper. In terms of bags for this and a lot of the outfits in this video, to be honest, you can interchange them. The outfits transition really well from one occasion to another. With this, I would probably go with a lighter like neutral or white bag, just because I think it pairs nicely with the jacket, but you're not going for a black that just kind of like completely blends in. But definitely something simple with this outfit. No gold hardware or anything like that. That is the way I think I would prefer to wear this. But I actually think with my Chloe Tess bag, like a brown leather croc bag, and then switching out for the boots that I have that are also like a brown croc, that would work really nicely and adds a different tone into this look. So if you wanted to soften it a little bit, that is definitely how you could do it. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to switch the boots out now. So this is the outfit with some brown tones added in. I really like this. I think the brown works really nicely with the creamy tones in the jacket. It just works really beautifully together. I think it just works nicely at softening the outfit, and you're adding like a little bit of an extra tone to the look, but without adding any like full on color, because we all know that is not my vibe. There are plenty of girls on YouTube that do that so well, but I'm just gonna stick with the neutrals forever, because this is just what I think suits me the best. But this is a nice way to be able to add like another tone into the look without going too crazy. Then we have this blazer, which is, for a blazer, quite like a thick heavy blazer, but I thought it made a really nice alternative to the pea coat that I showed earlier, and it's also in that really beautiful like classic Balmain-esque style. And I think those blazers are beautiful, very much out of budget for me, but also a lot of them seem, I know you can get different like fits, but I think the classic style is very fitted, and it's just not something that works really for me and my style. And with that in mind, I picked this Zara one up in a medium, so that it is hopefully a little bit more oversized, but also lends itself well to being worn throughout autumn winter, because you can layer stuff underneath it. So I will kind of show you how I style this up, and you guys can let me know what you think, whether it's worth keeping. But also, if you're in a warmer climate, this would be a much better alternative, because it is just that little bit lighter.
So for the blazer, I've paired it with one of my favorite pairs of boots, but these are actually from ASOS last year, sadly. However, the good news is that they have brought them back in a very, like, they literally tweaked, I think, the heel for this year's version. So I will link the updated version on ASOS in the info box for you guys. So I paired them with this blazer because they're both quite like smart, dressy items. But for the in-between, I've gone for a classic black roll neck, which is like my autumn uniform, a pair of like skinnies. So that's kind of what I've gone with underneath. It's pulled together, but it's not too dressy. And that was a real aim when putting this outfit together, was having the mix of the two, because the blazer can obviously look super smart and the boots are quite a smart, dressy item. So for the in-between, I've gone for something very, very simple, and the jeans casual it down. It's quite long for a blazer, but I did just want that little peep of like slightly washed black denim poking through, just to casual the whole thing down, make it not look too dressy. If I'd have gone leather trousers with this, I think it would just feel way too much for me. But obviously, in terms of like going forward into the future in an office environment, a black pair of like tailored skinnies. Zara usually do very good like tailored black trousers. Something like that would work really, really well switched out with this.
This next coat looked great on the website, but I'm not 100% sure it's gonna be for me, but I wanted to show you guys anyway, because it is a beautiful autumnal tone that I'm really enjoying at the moment. And thought some of you might enjoy it as well. If you like the pea coat but you're not a fan of a black coat, then I think you'll really like this one, because it's basically pea coat style. It's a little bit lighter, I would say, but it's in this lovely khaki color. I picked this up in a small and it was $79.99. I think this one is a little bit pricey for like the weight of it and just the overall feel. But like I said, if you are into the tone and you love a pea coat bit, basically pea coat fits are super flattering, because they're almost like, it's almost like an A-line short coat, if that makes sense. I might be describing that so wrong and people are like, no, that's not what pea coat is. But in my experience, that's kind of how it flies with a pea coat, and I've always found them so, so flattering. I used to be very conscious of my hips because they are the widest part of my body. I used to really try and hide that a lot, and that's why I loved my pea coat so much. Now I've got to a point where that is just the way my body rolls and I'm cool with it. But if you are more conscious, they are a fab coat shape to have in your wardrobe. So I'll show you how I would style this one up anyway, and let me know what you think. Maybe it is a winner.
Okay, the green jacket was a pleasant surprise. I love it so much more on and styled up in this way than I thought I would. It's actually a lot more floaty and oversized than the black pea coat. I think this is actually ideally how I would have liked the black pea coat to fit, and probably would be keeping that one if it fit this way, because I just really like kind of how wide it is. I don't know, I just feel like it feels a bit more casual. The other one feels quite smart and quite fitted. Both are a vibe. This one just suits me a little bit better. I just don't love the material of this, and it is much thinner, which I think is helping how the coat moves and sits, but it then also doesn't lean itself really well to being a very wintry coat. It's definitely more of an autumn spring vibe, but I love the styling of it with the black jeans and the black kind of like knee-high boots. These really dress it up. And with coats that have like almost this kind of A-line or like pokey outness at the bottom, I don't really know what to call it, just basically the way they are cut and they kind of scoop out, I think it's really nice to have like a knee-high boot, because your coat's doing this and your boot's almost doing this, so they almost meet. But as you can see underneath, I've just paired it with my classic autumn winter uniform. Nothing crazy going on here, but this is just the easiest way to dress so many coats. And you can switch out the jeans for different colors. I just prefer black because I prefer to have the most minimal color palette.
Okay, now I have some coats from a few other places and I'm so excited to show you these. This absolute beauty is from Karen Millen, but it's from Lydia Millen's edit with them. It actually comes with a belt that goes around the middle, which I don't have with me right now, it's in the other room, but I will show you its style both with the belt and without. I loved it with the belt, but when I tried it on without the belt, I was like, wow, this is just the most gorgeous coat. I'm so, so into it. I'm in love with the color. It's this beautiful forest green. And if you are a little bit vertically challenged like myself, I can confirm that this will still work. This coat still fits me, and I think it fits really well considering the fact that brands like Karen Millen generally tend to run very, very long. I was really not sure when I picked up this coat if it was gonna fit or whether it was gonna like fall past my ankles, but actually I was pleasantly surprised. It is long, but it's just not too long, which is fab. And I picked up in a size 10. In hindsight, I probably could have gone a size smaller so that it was a little bit more fitted on the shoulders.
So for the green coat, I've gone with the classic black roll neck and leather trousers kind of vibe. But yeah, this coat is, today, weirdly, it feels like it's swamping me a little bit more than usual. I'm not sure why. I can't remember if I like tried it on with like a different hairstyle or something like that, or maybe something a bit chunkier on underneath. I really can't remember. But actually, I do need to shout out the fact that Zara have a dupe for this coat. If you are like desperate to get your hands on a coat in this color, I'll see if it's still available on the website, because I saw it last night and I'll link it.
I really love this outfit. I think it works really well as like a workwear outfit. I know that's not really the vibe that any of us are like working towards right now in the UK. I don't know about anywhere else, but not everyone is like going into offices now. So like your workwear is kind of like gone out the window a little bit. But in terms of future, I can't say that. Why can I not say that? Future-proofing your wardrobe. If you were concerned about like getting wear out things like in the future, kind of like 2021, 2022, oh my God. I literally like skipping ahead a year. Like this year in 2021 are like write-offs. If you did want to like future-proof your coat purchase and you wanted something that is smart, then this is definitely one that I think would work really nicely when you are in an office environment. And the outfit underneath works really well in terms of that as well. I've just paired a little Givenchy bag with this look, and this is what it looks like with the winter sunnies. But anyway, that's how I would style this coat. I would go very kind of smart casual underneath it, not too smart if I'm not, because I'm not an office gal, but it would still look great with like shirts and more tailored pieces underneath. But for me, this is a definite smart casual vibe, a nice roll neck or a body, and then your leather trousers or skinny jeans and a cute boot. I do think this could also work kind of nicely with mom jeans. If you are taller, I think on me it would swamp me, but you could definitely go baggier and then a really nice tailored coat if you are taller. On me it would look an absolute joke, so we're just not even gonna attempt that today. I just know it won't look cute on me, but there are some people out there that could rock that look. Oh, I need to show you this with the belt. Please hold. You literally pop it on. I don't know why. I have to look in the mirror when I do this, even though I can't see what I'm doing. Okay. And then just pops on at the back. I love it with the belt. I think it's such a statement. It's such a gorgeous coat.
Our second to last coat is one from ASOS. They very kindly gifted this to me as part of some work that I'm doing with them, but I couldn't not include it in the autumn winter coat edit because it's so beautiful. It's a faux fur, but it feels really, really lovely. It doesn't feel too synthetic, like some faux fur coats just feel a bit like, you know, it feels so lovely, so soft. I picked this up in a size 10, so we'll see how it fits on. But I do like my faux fur coats a little bit more oversized. It's the most beautiful creamy tone. Oh, it's shorter in its length, but it's not too short, so it's kind of going to cover up your bum, I would expect. We'll see how it is when I try it on, but it's just absolutely stunning. It's got nice big pockets and lovely furry lapels on the front. It's really, really gorgeous.
I love this. Like, I love it so much. It is the softest, snuggliest coat. It's huge as well, so this is very much a winter coat for me. It's very big, very chunky. It does feel like there's a lot going on in terms of like material, which is why I don't love winter. Like, that is mainly the reason I don't love winter, is I don't like to feel swamped by clothing. But when it's freezing outside, you know, you don't really have like the most choice. I've paired it with my All Saints scarf that has like the All Saints kind of like monogramming logo on it, just for a little bit of extra texture, because I do find that sometimes from afar a fur coat, like especially this isn't like a chunky faux fur, it's got like no texture really to it until you're like kind of obviously up close. I think it looks nice to add a little bit of texture elsewhere, and I wasn't going to do that with the boots this time, so I decided to add a scarf. And because I added a scarf, I've gone for just like a cute little body underneath, which is like a faux sheep's wool material. I literally match my chair, but yeah, it's lovely. I'm so happy with the body. It's just an absolute dream to wear. And because we've got this kind of like V neckline coming down because of the scarf, and even when you take the scarf off, your coat is kind of making like a V shape here, I decided to keep my chest open and follow that down. But obviously if you're in a place that is very cold, you're not going to want to have like your coat open if you've got that bare chest, so a scarf is like essential.
And then because the coat is a very dressy coat, you can dress it up if you were like going out in the future and you had this coat, like, it would be gorgeous to throw on over like a little black dress, but obviously that is just not the vibe of 2020, so bear with me. The coat is very versatile, but I've decided to dress it down and pair it with my black skinny Sydney jeans and then my ASOS boots, which I just love. They're kind of like riding boots and they're very simple, but the kind of stretchiness at the back, I don't know if you guys can see that, it's got like a kind of ribbed stretchiness to it, and I think it makes the boots so interesting. I am obsessed with these and the fit is so nice. But I paired it with that just to even out my bottom half, because like I said, there's a lot of material going on the top here. It's very chunky, and actually this time last year I would have paired it with like my sock boots, my little pointed sock boots, but actually this year I'm really enjoying like balancing out my silhouette a little bit more. I like to streamline a look, but I'm not super, super hell-bent on it. And actually, I like having like a chunkier boot and a chunky coat, and it's very warm, and it's a more casual vibe, which is really, at the end of the day, the vibe of 2020. So yeah, that is how this outfit came to be. I hope you've enjoyed it. I really enjoy this outfit.
Let me know what you think of this coat. It's just an absolute dream. I hope it's still available by the time this video goes up, because it's just gorgeous. And then the final coat is my favorite of them all. I've been wearing this a lot off camera and trying not to wear it in like my what I wore in a week's and stuff like that. I picked this up from All Saints, so it is definitely a pricier purchase, but so worth it. There was also going to be another All Saints coat in this video, and I actually forgot and got a bit overzealous with my returns, so that one sadly went back, but I'll pop a picture of it here. But I just decided that it looks a little bit too like Matrix, and it could have worked maybe in a smaller size, but it was a very expensive coat and I was just so in love with this one, so I decided to keep this one. I sent the other one back, but this coat is in a stunning khaki color, as you can see, and it has these like quilted arms on them, and I just think it's a little bit different and so, so beautiful. It's such a gorgeous autumnal color, as I've said with about everything like khaki in this video. It has big pockets on it, which is obviously, as you can tell because I keep referencing it, is an essential for me. The quality of it feels lovely, and I still love both my All Saints jackets that I picked up last autumn winter. I think it was around like November time. They are still absolute staples in my wardrobe, and I think All Saints work really well at doing something that is like good quality but also like a really timeless piece in your wardrobe but that still feels special.
So the green quilted sleeve jacket definitely has to be one of my all-time favorite designs I think I've ever seen. I love this jacket so much. It's like the perfect statement casual jacket, which I didn't even think that was a thing. You can dress it up like I have now, but let me tell you, it works equally beautifully with just a regular like black hoodie, black leggings, and then just a pair of trainers. This works so beautifully on a casual basis. Also works really nicely in the way that I've paired it now with a pair of like lace-up Zara boots, because obviously we weren't going to get through this video without me mentioning those. My black skinny jeans, and then this jumper, which is from Topshop, I believe. I got it when I was doing some work with them, so it's like not fitted like the other roll necks in this video. It's a nice like floaty one, so when you take the jacket off it kind of still looks like a whole look, and I love that. But yeah, the coat over the top looks lovely. The style of it is smart, but the color, like I always think khaki lends itself to being a little bit more casual, and I really like that. So I paired it with the brown croc and like tan bag, and I think it works wonderfully together. So those very natural tones, but that are still very autumnal.
Okay, so this coat you won't have seen in the main part of the video. This arrived after I filmed my little sit down chat through. I wanted to show you this one anyway, and I've got a few others following this that I wanted to show you as well. This jacket is from ASOS. It's definitely more of a jacket. It's like faux sheep's wool material, I want to say. So lovely, so soft, so snuggly. It is showing up so much browner on camera. This keeps happening. This happened in another video I filmed the other day with a body. But I love this, and this isn't something that I would normally go for or that I would normally love, but I am obsessed with this. I think it works really nicely when paired with like leather trousers and a pair of pointed boots and a roll neck, like smart cash underneath, and a kind of dressier shoe. I think that juxtaposition is really nice because this is a very casual kind of coat, but I think it would look equally lovely with a more practical chunkier boot, or even if you're wearing like wellies on a dog walk, like if you've got a classic like green pair of wellies, they could look so cool. My wellies are unfortunately like a cherry pinky red. Not ideal, but yeah, I would love to know what you think. Do you like this? Because I love this.
It's so cute. It's so cute.
Yeah, so let me know what you guys think. This is up close. I really like the kind of like paneling that it has on it. It's really beautiful. This might actually be one of my favorite coats of the entire video. I don't know. Don't quote me on it, but I like it. Okay, so my final new contender into the ultimate coat edit, which is why I'm now calling it, because I can't believe how many coats I've put on in the past couple of hours. This has been a lot. This is my final new addition to this coat edit of 2020. This one is from Lorna Luxe's In The Style range, and I thought I'd give it a go, show you guys what the length looked like. But yeah, basically, this is where the Lorna Luxe In The Style coat would come to if you were 5'2". And this coat kind of works with anything. I've worn it with an oversized like sweatshirt and leggings and trainers, and it looks cute. But it also looks cute with like a nice little body and jeans and like a cute little pair of boots as well. I'm really into the base of this outfit as like an autumn winter staple. Like these boots especially, I'm really loving. And I think they work really nicely even when you take the coat off.
I've gone for my Chloe Tess bag with this coat because I think it works so, so beautifully. The tones work really wonderfully together, and it's kind of like a lovely brownie neutral vibe. And then the top underneath, I mean the body, like, is that creamy tone. So it all just blends really, really beautifully. And then you've got the black on the bottom half, which definitely cements that we are in winter, you know? For me, black is such a winter vibe, and then your browns and your tans are very autumnal, and they just mix really, really beautifully together. So that is kind of the look. Definitely less chunky than the ASOS coat, but still with like a similar vibe underneath. It just shows how the base of this outfit can transition and look very different from one coat to the next. But you definitely could put like a big roll neck on underneath and go for like a mom jean and a trainer, that kind of vibe. Trainers with this definitely make it a little bit more like Scandi chic. So yeah, that is this outfit. Do you like it? Do we like the coat? What do we think? The only thing I would say is when I wore this with leggings, that the fabric kind of did that thing that happens a lot with leggings, where if you've got like a textured coat, it's almost like you can feel it through the leggings, which I don't love, but that is like gonna happen with a lot of coats. It depends on how much you throw leggings on and then a coat like this. My outro outfit is like my true autumn winter uniform. You know when you've just like had enough of clothing? I'm just like, I'm done. Anyway, this autumn winter coat edit was actually really interesting for me, because trying to find like 10 different outfits to work with all of the coats was actually kind of difficult. Some of the coats aren't my normal type of coat that I would pick. I didn't want to just pick like 10 of the same type of coat for this kind of edit. There were definitely gaps in my wardrobe, I feel like, for some of the coats, but I did want to give some more variety, and it was actually very, very difficult. But I definitely was pleasantly surprised by some of the items that I really didn't think I was gonna love, like the little boxy faux sheep's wool jacket. I loved, and I could see working really well in my wardrobe and so many people's wardrobes. It's very, very versatile. The All Saints coat I love, and that was like a coat purchase for myself before this video was even happening. So that one is obviously like just staying in my wardrobe. It's like a staple winter coat for me. And the two ASOS jackets as well were just an absolute dream for me. So yeah, those were like my highlights. I would love to know yours, and if you could pick one, which one you would pick. So yeah, that is it for my autumn winter coat edit. Definitely veering more towards the autumn side of things. I feel like a lot of them were very light. Let me know if you are from a colder country and you would like to see an edit of more like heavier pieces. But yeah, that is going to be it from me today. Let me know your faves in the comments below. I hope you're all having the best day, and I'll see you guys again very, very soon. Bye.